what would you specifically do to try and change the current trajectory? And I want to ask that specifically in reference to Iran. What would you do about Iran?
I think the best way to contain Iran is to isolate Iran. And by that I mean getting more and more of the reasonable Arab countries to make agreements with Israel. Now, one of the things I'll give Donald Trump credit for was getting the Abraham Accords with the UAE, with Morocco. We already had agreements with Jordan and with Egypt. And I think the more of these countries that we can get to have friendly relationships with Israel, Iran, whose only goal is to wipe Israel off the map, becomes more and more and more isolated. I don't think you're going to necessarily do it by military action. I think you have to do it by putting more and more economic and diplomatic pressure on them to make them understand that it's not going to work. Second thing, we have to fix the Palestinian problem. And I think that this has once again shown that the delay that the Trump administration and the Biden administration put on a two-state solution contributed to what's going on right now. And so getting those more reasonable Arab countries to isolate Iran and then work with Israel to get that two-state solution. It won't be perfect, because there's always going to be some hostility there. But then the Palestinians will have their own territory to govern, and they're going to be responsible for it, rather than the Iranians, Hamas, Hezbollah, ginning people up in the West Bank and in Gaza towards violence because they say they're being repressed. Let's work on a two-state solution that allows them to vote, govern themselves, however they want to do it. And as long as they're not being violent towards their neighbors, then we can move on. The last thing is we have to make Iran very, very clear about the fact that them having a nuclear weapon is a non-starter for us. And if that would be the only way that I would want to take military action with Iran, if I became convinced from the intelligence that Iran was very, very close to developing a nuclear weapon, we'd have to take action, because as you see, with the kind of inhumanity based upon a perversion of Islam, because Islam is not a violent religion. It is being made violent by these people. They're using it as a way to weaponize their own power. So if they became very close to it, then I think we have to consider taking military action against them, because they blackmail us with that nuclear weapon and our friends, and we can't have that. So those are the ways that I would approach it with Iran in the Middle East. And I think if you're able to execute on all three of those ways, you make the region more peaceful than it is now, you make them responsible for governing amongst themselves because the relationships that they will have signed and developed. And you isolate Iran, with Iran knowing now that not only we're against them and their mission and their goal is to wipe Israel off the map, but if you can get Saudi Arabia to agree, if you can get Qatar to agree, you know, then where are they going? Who are going to be their allies in this? And then they have a real military problem, because if all of us are together in the region, there's no place for them to go. So that's the way I'd approach it. And I think there's a greater sense of urgency to it now than there has been for years, because of what's just happened recently. And I think it was a missed opportunity going all the way back to George W. Bush and through. They didn't push it through to a conclusion. Some of that has been the fault of people in the region, including Israel. But some of it's been the fault of the United States not to make it a priority. But every time something like this happens, we go, oh, wow, we really need to get to that. Well, it's time we need to get to it.